Won't interfere with your practice?
No, cannot interfere.
Nope. Yeah. Okay.
Welcome to Monday night's class. I've got a camera in the back of the room. We're recording the class tonight. And you're probably not in the frame. It's just a very simple test to see how the progress goes. I'm going to turn the music down just a little bit. For tonight's class, we're going to work to empower our bodies, fill ourselves up with spiritual power, prana, breath, all that good stuff. Center our mind within ourselves and allow ourselves to be in a place where we can be full of ourselves and just radiate light. So sitting down, letting your legs kind of root into the floor. Start to feel how you're feeling right now. You can bring your forefinger and your thumb to touch. And just from your wrists, allow your fingers to elongate. Feel the length of your whole arm. Just allow your arms to sit. Now feeling into your shoulders, just work your shoulders loose. And very, very slowly, from the base of your body, just move your pelvis. And just feel your legs rooting into the floor, just a little bit. As your legs center in your body, just allow your spine to be nice and straight. Let your spine sit tall. Take the crown of your head high and gaze straight ahead, sitting with really good integrity in the body, knowing that the body is a seat for ourselves in our life. It's true. So it's up to us to make sure we take care of it. It's up to us to make sure we breathe. It's up to us to make sure we take the time to rest. It's up to us to make sure that we practice to expand our limit, go to the place that will bring us new energy. With that being said, we'll slowly close our eyes, we'll slowly start to deepen our breath in our bodies, breathe all the way to the base of the floor, and feel your legs almost earthing, touching the floor, and start to deepen the breath inside your belly. Letting the breath have a smooth, free motion. Starting to deepen. Coming over the body. Allow your shoulders to become a little bit wider. Let your chest expand and start to feel your strength inside yourself. Now keeping the breath flowing nice and deep in the belly, start to feel into your upper chest area. Our upper chest area and upper back, this is the place for a lot of emotion. It centers our heart, and many things will arise through our practice. It's up to us to be conscious of what comes up, how we have to deal with it, and stay present throughout the movement. And start to channel the breath into your upper chest and upper back, letting your diaphragm, be nice and easy with slow, deep breathing. Maintaining the smooth breath inside the body, let's start by taking our right leg straight out. As this leg comes out, reach through the heel, bring your toes towards you. And just sit for a moment, let your torso grow tall, start to pull your navel into your body, pulling back to your spine, making your core tighter. Inhale deeply and slowly exhale to fold right over that right leg, then reach for that foot. Pulling this foot back, letting the pads of your feet open up. The more our feet open up, the stronger our roots are going to be into the floor. The stronger the roots into the floor, the more energy we can have in the body. It's vitally important to work on our feet. And very, very slowly, with a nice inhale, next time you inhale, rise up. Slowly bringing this leg in, we'll take the left leg out. Reach right through the heel, bring the toes towards you. Just sit for a moment and let your body settle. Whatever subtle adjustment you have to make on the inside, allow it to happen. And slowly breathing, exhaling all the air out of the body, squeeze so much air out, and slowly fold over. Reach for your toes. Pull your toes towards you. Allow the pads of your feet to open up. See strength all the way to the back of your leg, all the way from your heel to your head. On your next inhale, inhaling up to a seated position, we'll get both of our arms up. Now we'll be like this, we'll roll our shoulders open and inhale all the way up. Let your fingers rise high. Feel the pull in your chest to rise up. And slowly grab your fingers on the right hand and then lean over. Grow tall from your waist, a nice arc. Tendency could be to arc right here and we feel it right in this area. We want to feel it all the way down the side of your body. Try to keep a nice open chest for a deep breath. Pull your shoulders back as much as you can. Good job. And slowly inhale to center. Just wiggling your fingers out here. Exhaling deeply. Grabbing your opposite hand. Leaning over. If you can, slowly just take your gaze up, deep in that bend on your side body. Inhale back to neutral. We'll work through our arms right into our shoulders. So take your fingers out, and right in our shoulder girdle here, you can relax your shoulders as much as possible. Free up your neck. Slowly start to pump your hands, just nice and easy for starters. Yoga is about getting to our spine, so we have to work through all of our joints. Feel the joints right in your fingers, your wrists, your elbows, and your shoulders. And expanding your chest as wide as you can, and start to pump. Constantly breathing, letting the body move. While the attention is in the moment. Very slowly come to stillness. Turn your hands over. Feel a natural lift in your shoulders. Once you feel that, draw that into your body. Exhale your hands right behind you. Palm to palm, reach your triceps back, flexing your arms, open chest, leading with the chest, folding forward, and take your hands up.
work into your upper back and shoulders, just nice and easy. Whatever feels like, if there's any restriction, you want to breathe into it and allow it to open and release. On your next inhale, rising up, take your hands to the floor, releasing the palm to palm grip. We'll slowly come into tabletop position. Okay, working with your breath, allowing for a cat-cow, taking your hip bones back, growing tall out of your abdominal section, micro-bending your elbows, chest goes forward, and inhale. On your exhale to hunch. Flowing with your breath, however it may be tonight. Hang out in the forward fold. Our feet Feet will be about hip distance apart or big toes touching together, your preference. Then rocking your body, feeling the weight on your feet. Feel how you can place the weight on your heels and the front of the balls of the feet. Next time you come forward, feeling the weight on the balls of the feet, allow your heels to rise just a touch. So if there was like a sheet of paper, it could go under your heels. Maintaining that little bit of a lift, notice the energy in the legs. Bending at the knees, allow your torso to come close to your thighs. Then slowly start to elongate, straighten your legs, looking straight towards the floor, deepen your forward fold. Now notice, the more weight that you give right through your legs to your feet, the more rebound strength you get from the earth. It raises you up. We'll slowly ragdoll our body up. Nice strong legs, rising all the way up. Make space for your tailbone to curl through. Allow your torso and trunk to be long. Open your shoulders, palms up. Then inhale all the way up. Press towards your fingers. Reach and pull down right into your center. Now looking at your fingertips here, if there's any intention for the class that you'd like to make or dedicate your practice to someone or yourself, do that now. Notice how much more energy you get when you offer your practice in a service. It's universal. Exhale all the way down. Inhale all the way up. We'll fold right through. Touch down, inhale halfway, elongate, exhale all the way down. We'll slowly come back into our plank. Now let's establish a nice plank here. Press right into the floor, raise your midbone or your torso high for starters. Then we'll take our weight, we'll press it through our heels, squeeze your navel to your spine, then start to come like a flat board, full body straight, letting whatever adjustment needs to take place for it to happen. You're maintaining the straightness, hover all the way down, inhale forward, upward dog. Slowly pressing through. If you want to go tabletop to downward dog, you can, more than welcome. Inhale our right leg behind us. We'll bend at the knee. We'll slowly stack our hips. Reach. Opening up your right side of your body. Strong left leg. Bring this leg, right leg through the pigeon posture. Try to parallel the outside of your leg with your mat and the front of your shin in front of the mat. Take your back leg nice and straight and find a place that you want to work into tonight. Allowing your torso to shimmy and position into your hip socket. And slowly exhale and fold over. Now when I see you guys breathing here, I want to see your backs move. I want to see your back rise and fall with your breath. That's how deep I'd like for you to breathe. Make this posture, something that will look good. Feel strength in your arms. Hover down just a touch. Inhale deeply. On your exhale, let's kick this leg back. Slowly set it down. Walking off both sides. And finding stillness. Feel the heat that's generated in the body. Let's take our left leg behind us. We'll bend at the knee. We'll open the leg to stack the hips. Nice full body opening on the left side. On your next inhale, squeeze all the air out. Come into pigeon posture. Parallel the outside of your leg with the outside of the mat. Shimmy your shin so it's parallel with the front of the mat or close to. And flip your toe on the back leg. Find a place you want to work into your hip socket area. How do you want this to be for you? Once you find that place, let yourself collapse. Breathe deep. Toes under and slowly hover. As you hover, pick that lead leg up. Squeeze into your core. Build and generate strength. On your next exhale, take your left leg way behind you and set it down. Slowly come into hero's position, just for a second. Hero's position, our knees are almost parallel. Try to find a nice seam with the legs sitting. Letting your torso erect and sit tall. Now we'll work into a sound. The sound is long. However it resonates with the whole room, is with the first energy center in the base of the body. So we can close our eyes, breathe deep, and we can just chant the sound maybe 4 times. Multiple tones would be great. See your participation. Feel it. Let it fly from your body. Inhaling deep. Breathing here, contracting your navel and pulling it to your spine. making that connection. I'm going to say that a lot because I want it to become habitual for all of us. And we're slowly going to rise all the way up. As we do, we'll work into a little bit of a back bend. How that happens is we rise up, growing tall out of our lower back, shoot your hips forward, open up into your chest and arc back, feel and look at your hands. Slowly let yourself gaze a little bit further back. And rising all the way up. And slowly pull down into your body. Centering yourself here, looking straight ahead. Now feel both of your legs, feel the rootedness of your legs. We'll transition to tree. So pick any side that feels stronger for you first. You will choose the opposite foot. You can place it right on the floor. Grab your foot coming to your calf. Avoid your knee. Or place it way up into your thigh. Once you find placement for your leg, let your body settle. Release all the weight into your standing leg. Take your time. Let your breath arrive in the moment. Let your mind be clear. Once you're centered, allow yourself to grow. Now if you want to stay here, you can slowly start to part your hands and beat. If you want to feel a little bit deeper, start to take your gaze and take your eyes straight to the ceiling, trusting in your body. Start to take your gaze up, open your hands, and expand. This is the best afternoon posture. Lunch break, go and soak in the sun for like 2 minutes. You'll recharge your whole afternoon. Probably look pretty awesome doing it. And exhale your arms, releasing to the side. We'll bring this knee straight to the middle. And kick through this foot, doesn't matter how high it goes, nice straight leg. And slowly hinge at your hips. Let your leg be a counterbalance. Taking your gaze forward, arc into your upper chest like an upward dog. Open up your arms to fly. Slowly rise up. Release your left arch and work to the other side. So centering yourself in yourself, right leg becomes stronger, whichever leg you are on. You'll find placement for left foot. Opening up that left foot to the side. Take a moment to settle. Let your whole body become as one. Once you feel that strength inside yourself, if your hands are already up, that's perfectly fine. Feel free to go at your own pace. Raising your hands up. Find length in your body. Now if you want to take your gaze up, just shoot your gaze straight from the floor, straight to the ceiling. You can take your gaze and your face at a 45 degree angle, opening up your arms. Let your body fill. We worked into our first pranic center that's right in our pelvis and our legs. Our reservoir for energy is in our belly. The whole midsection. We have incredible reserve of energy. If we allow that area to be full of breath, we just hold energy there. And slowly exhale your hands to the side, taking our knees straight in front of us. Kick right through this foot, nice straight leg. And slowly find a counterbalance with your leg, reaching forward with your chest. Slide arc off your back and hover.
yourself feeling good. And slowly inhale up. And drop your foot down with each arch. Okay, continue through our float. So we'll start at the top of our mat. We'll inhale all the way up. We'll exhale to fold. Inhale to elongate your spine halfway. Exhale to fold. And come all the way back into your plank. Up all the way down. Inhale to upward dog. Really pressing through your hands. Nice strength in the body. Grow your neck out of your shoulders. And slowly transition to your downward dog.
Foot behind us, nice long leg, step it through to lunge, now we'll go more into triangle, so dropping the back foot to a 45 degree angle, the heel of the front foot comes into the arch of the back foot for alignment, and when you open to warrior two. Deep as you want to take your lead lunge, make sure you can see your big toe. When you can see your big toe, your body is able to really find that nice lunge. Then pressing through that lead foot, start to straighten the lead leg. Notice a nice triangle between all of our legs. Slowly move forward with your front fingers, pivot at the hip, let your top hand raise high. Come to the side of the room. A lot of the shoulders look really, really good, but there's one subtle thing. When we're in triangle here, there's a tendency,
I'm so used to it. It's like this, if the shoulder's like this, it's like rotated down. If we release this arm, we let the shoulder open, really open it up here that you can feel into your ribs. Let your ribs open up. The palm is straight. You'll feel the nice symmetry of your chest. A couple more breaths here. Top hand, the palm is nice and open. Micro bend into your front knee and slowly find warrior two.
From two, let's go back into downward dog.
Take a lead leg way behind us. Okay, let's raise our left leg behind us and we'll bring it through to lunge. Now heel to your heel so it meets your arch of your back foot. Feel a place where you feel nice strength and foundation with your legs. Slowly windmill open to warrior two. Now reach your fingers, expand your chest and your back at the same time, right from the center of your spine.
Visualizing your best posture, your best warrior two, and really feeling it using your imagination. Pressing into that lead foot, allowing that leg to straighten. Reaching forward. Start to pivot, tip. Take your top hand up. Opening up that shoulder to the best of your ability. Breathing deep into your ribs. Expanding your body. Slowly, if you can, take your gaze up to that top hand. Deep breaths here. Slowly micro bend into your front knee. Finding warrior two with a smooth transition. Slowly move through. Take your lead. back to hero's position. Slowly raising your torso up. Allow your spine to be tall. Allow your chest to be open, your back broad. And taking your chin parallel, looking straight. It's very important that our head is straight so the breath can go right into our nose all the way down. If we go like this, we're blocking off our channel. If we go like this, we're not symmetrical. So it's up to us to find that within ourselves to be straight. I know sometimes it's easy to look the other way. Let's take this time for ourselves. We'll slowly bring our hands to right underneath our navel. Now inside of our bodies, if you can feel this be a reservoir for yourself to store energy, feel that for yourself. The lower dantian. Slowly inhale up. Open to expand your hands. On your next exhale, bring your hands down, fanning all the way into your core, all the way down. And following your breath at your own rate, own speed, letting your hands open and close. This is also a retraction, a repulsion and attraction. When your hands come into you, feel attraction to the things that you want that serve you. Hands rise away from you, repel everything that doesn't serve you. Coming into harmony with home frequency, what that means for you. Next time your hands come down, keeping them in your lap. Rest your shoulders, rest your arms, just feel for a moment. Now take your attention into your eyes. Let the inner corners of your eyes soften. Let the outer corners of your eyes soften. Now with your sight, see things as you've seen them for the first time. Slowly open your eyes. Take the color in. Take the texture and the sight of the room into yourself. A lot of times with our sight, we're forced to look outside. That we can still be inside through practice. And when we meet the outside and the inside in that thin little line, it's a place where we find union of the two. And we'll slowly come back through to our downward dog. Angle, rotating your torso, take that little right hand out, the left hand comes back. Now finding this hand come parallel with the floor. Slowly reach through and scoop up. And exhale all the way down. Take it really way behind you.
Our foot, we'll expand our chest, and we'll just open both of our hips. Now, a tendency is for this leg to come in a little bit. We want this leg to be straight. So, both of our hips are nice and even. And just open into your chest to the best of your ability. Release your shoulders down your back, and take your left hand out. Releasing all the way down the left leg, open up your right knee. Slowly come back to neutral and step down. Ground our legs, raise our left leg up, we'll flex into the foot. Keeping both of our hips straight. Slowly take your hands forward. Pull on your knees so it allows you to open your upper chest. Stay strong in your back. Taking that right hand up. Slowly open up your knee. Breathing deep. slowly come to center and release. Now we'll count for yoga squat. So knees are in a place where both your knees are allowed to open. Sometimes mentally you have to talk to yourselves because it's a place where you hold weight sometimes. You don't want to do that. You want to take your weight straight down the legs, all the way to your heels, let our muscles compensate. So I'll go first and inhale up, I'll charge up, and just shoot my weight down. Give that a shot. Talk to your body, a little bit of body talk. Once you're down all the way, go for it. Let's come into our squat. Once we're here, just release into your hips as much as you can, creating a little bit of room and space. Then with your breath, start to rise your chest up, pulling your elbows into your knees, and pressing a little bit into the floor, taking your weight a little bit higher. Now generate strength here. Press into your hands and breathe. Second, we're going to push all the way up, shoot your hands straight through the ceiling, exhale all the air out of your body, on your next inhale, press all the way up, oh, slowly inhale all the way up, exhale to fold, inhale halfway, exhale to fold. All the way to your plank, last upward dog, give yourself a really good press, and transition, last downward dog, hips nice and high, take your heels close to the floor, and slowly come onto your knees, and roll all the way on your back, nice smooth motion. Allow your body to settle. Take your arms out to the side in a T position. We'll inhale our right leg up, knees pointing to the ceiling. Slowly intertwine our legs, crossing that right leg over the left. Now our legs are going to come to the right, let your left hip lift. Feel into the twist. A nice arc on the back of your body, all the way to your left fingertip. And if you want to take your gaze over to that side, really reach into the length of your arm. Slowly come to neutral. Once you come to neutral, take that right leg straight into the air, reaching through the heel. Nice open leg, reaching your leg to the front of the room. Once your leg touches down, draw your knee up to match the other knee. Inhale your left leg up, cross it over the right, and very, very slowly, allow your knees to come to the left, raise your right hip, promoting a nice arc of your back body, all the way to the extension of your right arm. Fingertip. Breathe deep. Let your side waist and belly rise and fall with your breath. Straight into the air, reach right through the heel, nice strong long leg, once it touches down, draw your knee up, and very, very slowly, just letting your knees fall to one side and the other, promoting a nice unity of the whole body, a deep twist in your midsection, flowing with movement.
Next time you come to the right, holding still in the center. Let your body settle, make space for your tailbone. Curl your lower back to touch the floor. Inhale your right leg straight up. And bend it so your ankle meets your knee. Now keep your right foot flexed and your right knee starts to go away from you. So it starts to point towards the front of the room. Feel a little bit of engagement right in your hip flexor area. And very, very slowly and gently start to curl your legs into your torso. Keeping your feet flexed, reach through the hole that you made. And start to give yourself a tug. Breathing deep into your hip socket. After a couple of breaths, you're going to notice that area gets packed with breath. It also gets packed with energy. When you feel that fullness, let it rise up your spine. Straight into the air. Reach your heel away from you. Once your leg touches down, slowly drop your knee. Inhale your left leg straight up. Cross your legs so your ankle comes to your knee. Keeping your feet flexed. Relax both of your hips here. Curl your tailbone so your lower back comes to the floor. Reach your left knee away from you. Feeling that little bit of engagement in your hip flexor area. Draw your legs up. Take a deep breath in. Exhale all the air out of the body. Bless you. And slowly reach through and pull your legs into your torso. Flexing your feet. Channeling all the breath into your left hip socket. Filling that area up with your breath. And once that area feels full of energy, pump that energy up your body. On your next exhale, leg straight into the air. Nice straight leg. Reach right through. Once your heel touches the floor, draw up your knee. Both knees towards the ceiling. Reaching for your knees, drawing your knees into your torso. And slowly letting each knee reach for each shoulder. Release deeply in your groins here. Letting a widening happen. Take it as far as you feel comfortable. And slowly reach for your feet with your hands. Come into happy baby. Feet go towards the ceiling. Now if this feels good to you, stay here and just start to rock. If you want to go a little bit deeper into the posture, we're going to try to bring our whole back onto the floor. So first we're going to start by squeezing our shoulder blades and rotating our arms so our upper back can come to the floor. And working all the way down, feel into your lower back. Feel into your tailbone and see if you can bring your lower back closer to the floor. If your whole back is on the floor, kick your feet out into a full expression. One more powerful extension. Slowly release. Let go of the grip of your hands on your feet. Take your left foot out, followed by your right. And just have gentle little movement towards your legs, relaxing and releasing the muscles. Separate your feet about 8 to 12 inches apart. slowly let your feet splay open. And taking your time to scan your body, making any minute adjustment that you need, and opening up your palms. Arch your arms about 30 degrees away from your torso. Gently close your eyes. Very well done, everybody. Enjoy the fruits of your practice. Turn the lights down. good place to stay there. Let my voice be ambient. We're going to work through a body scan for those of you that are awake and your body is still. Deep in your breath. Now, with that control and awareness of your breath, run your breath all the way down your right leg. Relax and release the muscles of your inner thigh, your quadricep, your hamstring. Work all the way past your knee, down your ankle, shin, your calf, all the way down towards your ankle. Feel your foot and breathe all that awareness all the way into your foot. Relaxing and releasing the right leg, draw your awareness all the way up back into the center of your body and focus on your left side. Channel your breath, relaxing and releasing the muscles of your inner thigh, your quadricep, and your hamstring. Breathe past your knee, working all the way down your shin, your calf, and your ankle. Become aware of your foot and channel all your breath and your awareness into your foot. Let your left leg deeply relax and release. Then slowly draw your awareness up your left side, all the way into your central body, feeling all the way up your torso, all the way up to your shoulders, and running down both of your arms. Relax and release your triceps, your biceps, your inner elbows, your forearms, your wrists, and feel into your hands, taking your breath and your awareness all the way into your palms, full of life, vitality and energy, and draw your awareness all the way up your arms, relaxing and releasing your arms, taking your awareness up into your neck, feeling the heaviness of the back of the head, working all the way to the crown of the head. If there's anything, you can softly relax on the top of your crown, let a subtle opening. Feel the relaxation that comes over your face to reveal your natural face, melting all tension away. And take your awareness back into your torso. And feel the quality of being that you've made for yourself. Slowly start to deepen our breath. We'll start to arrive back in our bodies, taking our time. Feel all the way down into your toes and your fingers, giving yourself time to feel and wiggle into each and every toe, each and every finger. Once you feel that connection in your body, start to rotate your hands and your feet about your limbs, promoting a nice lubrication of your joints. Then when it's time for you to move, move into any stretch your body's calling for. Your wits about you, keeping your eyes closed, slowly coming to a seated position, pressing off your right hand, and close the cross off by just chanting. Sitting in a posture where your breath can be free, where your sound is robust, and really just observing your own sound, how much deeper it is in when you're relaxed. Breathing deep, nice and softly.
Which is good.
Your name is?
I'm Chantal.